here, we have a stream of information, right? A string of letters, okay? So what is it? It's S-T-E. All right. So what's the next letter?
Well, that depends on a seven-letter word for a ciliate protozoan.
Dad, ignore the clue.
Well, it could be anything. It could be a stencil, a steeple, a stellar. It could be anything.
Not anything, Dad. Just a lot of things. See, absent other information, clues, we don't know what the next letter is going to be. But since there are letters that are more likely to be the next letter in the sequence than others, like A or E, or like R...
I see what you're saying, so it's not completely random.
It's called information entropy. See, you're bounded by the alphabet. 26 possibilities, further bounded by the inventory of the English language. So, what is our poisoner's boundaries?
Right. Well, I mean, look, he only messed with Graybridge's drugs.
So that's one boundary. Okay, now you might make geographical assumptions as well, right? I mean, it's not likely he's going to jump on a plane to Idaho for the next attack.
Yeah, but you're still casting a very wide net.
Can you narrow it down using your entropy thing so that we could pinpoint where he might hit next?
Well, given the limited data set you're talking about, all the work I have to do, I mean, it's not like I can just, you know, whip up a magic formula for every single problem.
No, well, that's not what you said last Friday.
Yeah. I mean, you did have a couple beers at
home. It's four beers. And it's stentor.
What is stentor?
Ciliate protozoan.